Surah 13 of the Holy Quran, translated by Muhammad Habib Shakir. This LibriVox recording is in the public domain. Surah 13, the thunder, Ar-Ra'd, revealed at Mecca. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. Alif, Lam, Mim, Ra. These are the verses of the book, and that which is revealed to you from your Lord is the truth, but most people do not believe. Allah is He who raised the heavens without any pillars that you see, and He is firm in power, and He made the sun and the moon subservient to you. Each one pursues its course to an appointed time. He regulates the affair, making clear the signs that you may be certain of meeting your Lord. And He it is who spread the earth and made in it firm mountains and rivers, and of all fruits He has made in it two kinds. He makes the night cover the day. Most surely there are signs in this for a people who reflect. And in the earth there are tracts side by side, and gardens of grapes and corn and palm trees, having one root and others having distinct roots. They are watered with one water, and we make some of them excel others in fruit. Most surely there are signs in this for a people who understand. And if you would wonder, then wondrous is their saying. What? When we are dust, shall we then certainly be in a new creation? These are they who disbelieve in their Lord. And these have chains on their necks, and they are the inmates of the fire. In it they shall abide. And they ask you to hasten on the evil before the good. And indeed, there have been exemplary punishments before them. And most surely, your Lord is the Lord of forgiveness to people, notwithstanding their injustice, and most surely your Lord is severe in requiting evil. And those who disbelieve say, why has not a sign been sent down upon him from his Lord? You are only a warner, and there is a guide for every people. Allah knows what every female bears, and that of which the wombs fall short of completion, and that in which they increase, and there is a measure with him of everything. The knower of the unseen and the seen, the great, the most high, alike to him among you is he who conceals his words and he who speaks them openly, and he who hides himself by night, and who goes forth by day. For his sake there are angels following one another, before him and behind him, who guard him by Allah's commandment. Surely Allah does not change the condition of a people until they change their own condition. And when Allah intends evil to a people, there is no averting it, and besides him, they have no protector. He it is who shows you the lighting, causing fear and hope, and who brings up the heavy cloud. And the thunder declares his glory with his praise, and the angels too for awe of him. And he sends the thunderbolts and smites with them whom he pleases, yet they dispute concerning Allah. and he is mighty in prowess. To him is due the true prayer, and those whom they pray to besides Allah give them no answer, but they are like one who stretches forth his two hands towards water, that it may reach his mouth, but it will not reach it. And the prayer of the unbelievers is only in error. And whoever is in the heavens and the earth makes obeisance to Allah only, willingly and unwillingly, and their shadows too at morn and eve. Say, who is the Lord of the heavens and the earth? Say, Allah. Say, do you take then besides him guardians who do not control any profit or harm for themselves? Say, are the blind and the seeing alike, or can the darkness and the light be equal, or have they set up with Allah associates who have created creation like his, so that what is created became confused to them? Say, Allah is the creator of all things, and he is the one, the supreme. He sends down water from the cloud, then water courses flow with water according to their measure, and the torrent bears along the swelling foam and from what they melt in the fire for the sake of making ornaments or apparatus, arises a scum like it. Thus does Allah compare truth and falsehood. Then as for the scum, it passes away as a worthless thing. And as for that which profits the people, it tarries in the earth. Thus does Allah set forth parables. For those who respond to their Lord is good, and as for those who do not respond to him, had they all that is in the earth and the like thereof with it, they would certainly offer it for a ransom. As for those, an evil reckoning shall be theirs, and their abode is hell, and evil is the resting place. Is he then who knows that what has been revealed to you from your Lord is the truth, like him who is blind? Only those possessed of understanding will mind. Those who fulfill the promise of Allah and do not break the covenant, and those who join that which Allah has bidden to be joined, and have awe of their Lord, and fear the evil reckoning. And those who are constant, seeking the pleasure of their Lord, and keep up prayer and spend benevolently out of what we have given them, secretly and openly, and repel evil with good. As for those, they shall have the happy issue of the abode. The gardens of perpetual abode, which they will enter along with those who do good, from among their parents and their spouses and their offspring. And the angels will enter in upon them from every gate. Peace be on you because you were constant. How excellent is then the issue of the abode. And those who break the covenant of Allah after its confirmation and cut asunder that which Allah has ordered to be joined and make mischief in the land, as for those, upon them shall be curse, and they shall have the evil issue of the abode. Allah amplifies and straightens the means of subsistence for whom he pleases, and they rejoice in this world's life, and this world's life is nothing compared with the hereafter, but a temporary enjoyment. And those who disbelieve say, why is not a sign sent down upon him by his Lord? Say, surely Allah makes him who will go astray and guides to himself those who turn to him. Those who believe and whose hearts are set at rest by the remembrance of Allah, now surely by Allah's remembrance are the hearts set at rest. As for those who believe and do good, a good final state shall be theirs and a goodly return. And thus we have sent you among a nation before which other nations have passed away, that you might recite to them what we have revealed to you, and still they deny the beneficent Allah. Say, He is my Lord. There is no God but He. On Him do I rely, and to Him is my return. And even if there were a Quran with which the mountains were made to pass away, or the earth were traveled over with it, or the dead were made to speak thereby, nay, the commandment is wholly Allah's. Have not yet those who believe known that if Allah please, He would certainly guide all the people? And as for those who disbelieve, there will not cease to afflict them because of what they do a repelling calamity, or it will alight close by their abodes. Until the promise of Allah comes about, surely Allah will not fail in His promise. And messengers before you were certainly mocked at, but I gave respite to those who disbelieved. Then I destroyed them. How then was my requital of evil? Is He then who watches every soul as to what it earns, and yet they give associates to Allah? Say, give them a name. Nay, do you mean to inform him of what he does not know in the earth? Or do you affirm this by an outward saying? Rather, their plans are made to appear fair-seeming to those who disbelieve, and they are kept back from the path, and whom Allah makes err, he shall have no guide. They shall have chastisement in this world's life, and the chastisement of the hereafter is certainly more grievous, and they shall have no protector against Allah. A likeness of the garden which the righteous are promised. There flow beneath it rivers, its food and shades are perpetual. This is the requital of those who guarded against evil, and the requital of the unbelievers is the fire. And those to whom we have given the book rejoice in that which has been revealed to you, and of the confederates are some who deny a part of it. Say, I am only commanded that I should serve Allah and not associate anything with him. To him do I invite you, and to him is my return. And thus have we revealed it, a true judgment in Arabic. And if you follow their low desires, after what has come to you of knowledge, you shall not have against Allah any guardian or a protector. And certainly we sent messengers before you and gave them wives and children. And it is not in the power of a messenger to bring a sign except by Allah's permission. For every term there is an appointment. Allah makes to pass away and establishes what He pleases, and with Him is the basis of the book. And we will either let you see part of what we threaten them with, or cause you to die. For only the delivery of the message is incumbent on you, while calling them to account is our business. Do they not see that we are bringing destruction upon the land by curtailing it of its sides? And Allah pronounces a doom. There is no repeller of His decree, and He is swift to take account. And those before them did indeed make plans, but all planning is Allah's. He knows what every soul earns, and the unbelievers shall come to know for whom is the better issue of the abode. And those who disbelieve say, "You are not a messenger." Say, "Allah is sufficient as a witness between me and you, and whoever has knowledge of the book." End of Surah 13.